Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, today is an historic occasion for Papua New Guinea. And today is also an historic day for our Grand Chief, Sir Michael Somare, and for our National Parliament. I can say with certainty that the record that we are honoring today is certainly going to take a long time to repeat. Today is exactly 49 years since Sir Michael took his seat in the House of Assembly in Port Moresby. It is very fitting that on this day, April 4, that we recognize the service of the Grand Chief to the Parliament and to the nation. The period of 49 years, Mr. Speaker, in the National Parliament and the House of Assembly that has preceded is certainly a record not only in our country, but also in the Commonwealth. Sir Michael Somare was elected to the House in 1968, well before most of our 8 million Papua New Guineans were even born. I know that this House acknowledges and expresses our gratitude for his service to our nation. After being elected Chief Minister in 1973, he and a group of our young leaders then encouraged our people to gain independence. There were very many who said that Papua New Guinea could not become independent nation for many decades to come. The doubters also said that our people could not run their own affairs. We could not manage our foreign policy. We could not manage our security forces. And certainly we could not manage our treasuries. He fought against intolerance and doubt, often based on racial bias, and told the world that Papua New Guinea could and would be an independent state. His position was supported by many eminent people of our nation, and he turned that support into a plan for independence. The special contributions by people like Sir John Guise, our first Governor General, the Right Honourable Member for New Ireland, Sir Julius Chen, our first Finance Minister, and many others in that critical period of our history is a fact that we shall never forget. Many of the leading Papua New Guineans are no longer with us, but their contribution and support for independence is now in the annals of the history of our nation. The likes of Sir Marukiki, Sir John Guise, Sir Thomas Cavalli, Sir Yambaki Okuk, and there are far many more for me to continue to mention their name, but we remember them. These are the founding fathers of our nation, are immortal in our hearts for every Papua New Guinea. Their contribution that laid the foundations of this great nation we will continue to build. The Grand Chief was supported during this transition to independence by some of the most prominent Papua New Guinean departmental heads who served with distinction. This includes people like the late Sir Anthony Siaguru, Sir Rabi Namaliu, Sir Buri Kidu, to name a few. While the world was going through a process of decolonization in those times, and the impact of this change on all countries achieving independence around the world was profound and far-reaching for their citizens. While our people had tens of thousands of years of being in charge of their own destiny, the decades of colonial rule has brought about significant change in our country, some of which were positive, that delivered improved quality of life, religion, education, and healthcare. But there were also many elements of freedom that our people desired to be returned to the men, women, and children of our country, that is our land. It is very important for every person to know that they are in charge of their own destiny. It is important for us to have our own government, who will manage our own affairs, who have the right to elect a government on their free will. While Sir Michael Somare is a driving force in the development of our national constitution, this has made it possible for us to have a remarkable, smooth transition to independence. This was not the same story for many other countries that has transitioned from colonial rule to independence during those periods. Mr. Speaker, our move to independence was peaceful, organized, that has now laid the foundations for the great nation we have today. Sir Michael Somare negotiated with the Whitlam government in Canberra and, of course, with the Australian opposition, led by Malcolm Fraser. Agreements were set that served our country well in the early years, especially those challenging years of our nationhood. His government forged relationship with many other great partners in the international community, the United States of America, People's Republic of China, the United Kingdom, Japan, New Zealand, Indonesia, and so many other countries. Mr. Speaker, he played a leading role in establishing our presence in the United Nations, the Group of 77, the Melanesian Spearhead Group, and the South Pacific Forum, as it was known then. As the head of a newly independent nation, Sir Michael Somare firmly established our presence in the global community. Mr. Speaker, with our growing international reputation, Sir Michael Somare was also firmly focused on national development and building our nation at the domestic level. In the land of 1,000 tribes, people from such remote and diverse locations, his government set out a purpose of building a sense of national harmony, Mr. Speaker. In the years around the first post-colonial decade, under the government of his leadership, followed by Sir Julius Chen and followed by Pius XX later, they turned this country from a diverse country into a united nation. Today, Mr. Speaker, we tend to take our national unity and harmony for granted, but achieving this social cohesion, Mr. Speaker, took a lot of hard work. Again, we only have to look at the fate of so many other newly independent nations around the world of that era and understand how things could have gone differently. In many other countries, the divide of ethnic and cultural difference has led to civil war and genocide, but not here in Papua New Guinea. Our national unity and harmony underpins the wonderful democracy that we enjoy today. From the very outset, Sir Michael Somare and our founding fathers believed that national unity in a country as diverse as ours was of paramount importance. Mr. Speaker, the Right Honourable Governor of New Ireland, the Right Honourable Governor of Western Islands, the Leader of Opposition, and a number of us who have served as ministers in the governments led by Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare. This capacity to work together, even before and after periods of political disagreement, is a testament to the democracy that we have in our country built by our founding fathers. While we may not always agree on issues, we all believe in the supreme good of the independent state of Papua New Guinea. That is a sentiment that binds us all together in this honorable house. We all come here to this parliament to serve the greater welfare of the people of Papua New Guinea, to serve the ideals set forth by our founding fathers, as was demonstrated by our first prime minister. Mr. Speaker, I was privileged to serve as a minister in governments led by Sir Michael Somare. We might not have always seen eye to eye, but I am grateful for the opportunity and the grounding that that experience gave to me. After the elections of the national government in 2012, Mr. Speaker, I was proud to have Sir Michael serving on the government side of this house. In this ninth parliament, we have not always agreed, but Mr. Speaker, that is the nature of politics. But we have a robust and a vibrant political system in our country where members of parliament are free to voice their opinions and vote as they choose. This is the system of government that our founding fathers have built and the foundations on which we continue to work. Mr. Speaker, it remains for me to pay a very special tribute to Grand Chief's family, who have been the rock, who have been his rock over such a long period of public life. I know that the House and the nation will join me in expressing our gratitude and best wishes to Lady Veronica. We thank her for a wonderful support for Grand Chief right throughout his long career in this house. I also want to thank his children who have supported him and contributed in their own way to our nation and our community. Honorable members and Mr. Speaker, I thank the Grand Chief Sir Michael Somare for his contribution to Papua New Guinea, to the National Parliament, and for guiding this nation through independence. This house will be a different place when we return for the 10th Parliament, which convenes later this year. We will certainly miss his wisdom and his knowledge and the experience that only comes with 49 years of elected service. I wish the Grand Chief and Lady Veronica a long and happy and healthy retirement. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.